Sometimes you might want to estimate a model based on datasets that come from different studies for the same molecule. In that case, different error models can be used for the different studies while keeping the same population model. This is what I am going to show in this video. In this Monolix project, the dataset contains measurements from three different studies, indicated in the column study. If I tag this column as a categorical covariate, then the predicted observations from all studies are described with the same observation model that I can see on the tab Statistical Model and Tasks by clicking on this formula. Here, the error model is a combined model with two population parameters A and B that are the same for all individuals. But observations from different studies are often better described with different error models. Indeed, when I check the plot observation versus predictions on log-log scale, split by study, I notice that the shapes differ in the three plots. In particular, the studies 1 and 2 have a straight shape in log-log scale that is characteristic of a proportional error model, while the combined error model seems appropriate for the study 3. Moreover, when I add the 90% prediction interval and the percentage of observations that fall outside this interval, I can see that the percentage of outliers is quite different for each study. This is also a hint that a specific error model for each study could be more appropriate. To this end, a solution is to tag the column study from the dataset as observation identifier. This defines three different types of observations that will be matched to three different outputs. It will be then possible to define one error model per output. When I click on Accept, a message warns me that some IDs have only one type of observations. This is normal. Then I need to edit the structural model to define three outputs to match the observation types. I still want to use the same PK model for the three studies, so I can just duplicate twice the PK concentration CC as CC2 and CC3 that I then add to the outputs. I then save and load it in Monolix. Since three outputs are defined in the structural model, there are now three observation models in the interface that use three different error models. Based on the previous diagnostic plot, I can choose a proportional error model for the studies 1 and 2, and different error model parameters will then be estimated for the three studies. B for the study 1, B2 for the study 2, and A3 and B3 for the study 3. I can now save my project. I then estimate the parameters. You can note that the three studies are now represented as distinct plots because they are associated with distinct outputs. This example can also be found on our online documentation. See you next week!